In this video, we're going to talk about amortization tables and what they are and then how to make them in Excel. So an amortization table is a really useful tool that shows you how your money is being distributed as you pay back a loan. And what some people don't realize is when you're paying back a loan, equal parts don't go to principal and payment the whole time. The bank has it set up to make sure that they get their money first. And you'll see as we make these, when you're first paying back a loan, initially you're paying everything to the bank and very little is going to actually pay off the principal of the loan itself. But then near the end of the loan, more and more money is going to pay for the principal. So we're going to see how do we set up a chart that shows you the breakdown of your monthly payment and how much goes to interest and how much of it goes to principal. So I've created a template for you here. And the first thing that we're going to need to do is figure out what is our monthly payment. So we're going to use our favorite friend, our PMT function, where we take our, in Excel, let's see, I'll go and type it in, we do equals PMT, and then it's our APR divided by N, comma, N times Y, comma, negative P, just like we did in the previous section. And that will tell us our monthly payment, and it's not working now because I don't have any numbers in there. And then in our chart, we're going to use that, and we'll have a, let's see, we'll have a couple different columns. Our first column tells us what payment number we're on. So payment number zero is when you first borrow the money. So it's the initial value, it's how much you owe, and it's going to be blank across because we haven't paid anything, but our initial loan balance will be however much we borrowed. So payment zero represents the initial time we take out the loan, and that will tell us our total amount borrowed. Then starting with payment one, payment two, all the way to the end, our payment amount's going to be the same every month. We're going to assume for this class it's always the same. So we'll type in the number that we got from our monthly payment above and put that all the way down the column in our payment amount. In real life, you might vary how much you pay on a monthly basis, but for this class, to keep things simple, we're just going to use consistent payments. Then the next thing to calculate our interest, we're going to use the formula. It's equals APR, so our annual percentage rate divided by 12, times our previous month's balance. And this will show how much of your money is going to go to the bank in interest that they're earning. Then to get our amount to principal, we'll take our total payment minus the amount that the bank is getting in interest, and that's going to show you how much you're actually paying down on your loan. And then to get our next month's loan balance, we'll take our previous balance minus what we just paid down to principal. And what's fabulous about Excel is if we use cell references, we'll be able to type in four or five different formulas, and then we'll drag it all down and get a whole bunch of numbers all at once that'll tell us a lot about the loan. So let's do this. It'll make more sense when we do it. So I'm going to go over to example one, and we want to create an amortization table for the scenario where we're borrowing $7,500 at 14% interest to be paid back in monthly payments over 5 years. So the first thing we need to do is figure out our monthly payment. So we need to create our PMT function, which is our APR divided by N, N times Y, negative P. So our APR is 14%. N, we're doing monthly, so that's 12 times. Years, 5 years, and then we're borrowing $7,500. So we're going to be making payments of $174.51 in this scenario. So then setting up my chart, we've got to get our payment number, then our payment amount. I'm going to make these pretty here in a second. Then our interest paid, then amount that goes to principal, and then our new loan balance. Just wind these up. Okay. Looks pretty good. All right, so we're making payments over the course of 5 years. So there's 5 years times 12 payments a year. So 5 times 12 will give us 60 total payments. So I need to list out 1, 2, 3, all the way down to 60 in my payment number column, because if I make 12 payments a year for 5 years, that's going to be 60 total payments. So I'm going to take it down to 60. And so we'll have a payment for every single one of those months. And again, is time 0 represents when you first make the loan. We're not paying anything then. We don't have any going to interest. We don't have any going to principal. For time zero, that's just going to represent our balance, which is the $7,500. So now what happens? First month comes around, you owe money. We're going to pay $174.50 51 every single month. That payment value that we calculated, we're going to pay that every single month. So I'm going to drag that down the whole column to represent I'm going to make 60 equal payments of $174.51. So now I need to calculate the interest that's being paid each month. So the formula that we have is equals, then it's our APR, which is 14%, divided by N, which is 12, times our payment amount. No, times our balance, I'm sorry. Our loan balance is the 7,500, and I'm gonna use a cell reference for that number because again, cell references make it very easy to drag. I don't wanna have to type this stuff in 60 times, that would be annoying. So it's our APR divided by 12 times our balance. And then I'm gonna drag that down, and it's gonna show a bunch of zeros, don't worry about that. It'll get fixed once we finish out the chart. I'm only half of the way done. So then our amount to principal is our payment minus the part that goes to interest. Remember I told you the bank makes sure they get their money first. So the amount that's actually going to pay down your loan is whatever's left over once the bank takes their money. So in this case, the bank is going to get $87.50 of your payment, and then everything that's left over goes to principal. So in our first month, we're actually paying more to interest than we are to actually pay off the loan. It's kind of crazy. And I'm going to drag that down, and again, it's going to look kind of funny because we're not done. And then our final step is taking our previous balance minus what we just paid down in principal. So we reduce the amount that we owe on the loan from $7,500 down to $7,412.99. And I'm going to take that and drag it all the way down. And just to make my chart look prettier, I'm going to change all of these to two decimals. Just so it looks like money. When you have a bunch of crazy decimals, that's hard to read. So what we're seeing here is we started off by borrowing $7,500. We're making payments of $174.51 every single month for 60 months. Initially, we have $87.50 going to interest and $87.01 going to principal. You notice every single month, the amount to interest changes and the amount to principal changes. And we see initially, the interest paid goes down while amount to principal goes up. And this is always going to happen. You always pay the most interest at the beginning of the loan, and then you pay more and more of the principal as you go forward. And that's why sometimes refinancing isn't the best idea. If you refinance and basically get a new loan to pay off an old loan, if you do it too often, all you're ever doing is paying interest, and you're never actually getting rid of the amount you owe. So you want to be very careful when the bank is trying to sell you on a loan, because they're going to be making money off of you. But we can see over the course of the 60 months, the amount of our loan balance goes down and down and down and down. And as we get close to the end, we see almost our entire payment is now going to the principal. Our last payment, the bank only makes $2.01 in interest, and $172.50 goes to principal. So there's a couple interesting things to notice, you know, in addition to the whole interest changing and principal changing. But we actually have a balance at the end of 16 cents. So sometimes we have, it can be up to a dollar or two. It's usually a very small amount left over at the final month. And sometimes we overpaid by just a little bit. In this case, we've underpaid. We still owe 16 cents. So what we're always going to do is assume that you can come up with a dollar or two in change if you need to pay off a loan. And we want to adjust this last month's payment. We want to up it by 16 cents. So let's see, 51 plus 16 would be 67. Yeah, there we go. So I increased my last payment by 16 cents so that I zeroed out the loan so that now we've officially paid it off. You don't want to have 16 cents left on a loan and have it go to collections or something crazy like that. You would find a way to pay off the last little bit. So the one exception to equal payments is sometimes the last month we need to adjust it up to maybe a couple dollars more or a couple dollars under, depending on how the numbers work out. So a couple interesting things that we can look at here. We can look at some totals. So I'm going to sum all my payments. This will tell us the total amount that we paid towards the loan. So you borrowed $7,500, and to pay off the loan, you're paying $10,470.76. The total amount we paid in interest, I'm going to sum my interest column. You're paying almost $3,000 in interest on this loan. And then the amount to principal, let's add that column up. The amount's principal is the $7,500. That's the principal. That's how much you borrowed. And then your total amount paid, or your, actually, no, that wouldn't make any sense. That would be adding up all the different balances. That doesn't make any sense. We don't want to do that. All right, well, but we do want to look at the total amount paid, the amount to principal. So total amount paid was over $10,000. Amount to principal was the $7,500 that you borrowed, and then the amount to interest was almost $2,970.76. So you gotta ask yourself, you know, I needed $7,500 and I ended up paying almost $3,000 in interest. That's almost half of the original amount. You know, was it worth getting the money and paying extra interest so I could have the whatever item it was right away? Or maybe would it have made more financial sense to save up and pay cash for whatever it is? And, you know, that's really up to you. Sometimes you might need something and it might be worth paying the interest. Other times it might be smarter to wait and save up your money and have that extra money in the bank. Because I don't know about y'all, but $3,000 goes a long way in my life. So that is an amortization table. Let's do another one. Example two. So now we're creating the amortization table if we borrow $8,000 at 10% for 6 years with monthly payments and then a 5% down payment. All right, so we're making a 5% down payment. That means we're not actually going to borrow $8,000. It means we're paying $5,000 of it upfront. So, or we're paying 5% upfront. So let's figure out what that 5% is. So 5% of $8,000 is $400. So I'm really only borrowing $7,600. So since I'm making a 5% down payment, that means I'm going to be paying 5% of the loan up front. I'm really only borrowing $7,600 in money. So coming up with my chart, we've got our APR, NY, P, and FV. PMT. Payment function. So it's our PMT of APR divided by N, comma, N times Y, comma, negative P. So our APR is 10%, N is 12, we're making monthly payments, Y is 6 years, and our principal, what we're borrowing, is actually $7,600. So this time we're going to have payments of $140.80. So sitting at my chart, we've got payment number, payment amount. Wow, I cannot spell today. Interest paid. Amount to principal. And then our current loan balance. Let me make these wider. So time zero is when we borrow the money. We haven't paid anything, so there's nothing in the first three columns. Our loan balance is $7,600. Then this time we're doing 6 years. So 6 years of 12 payments a year will be 72 total payments. So I need to make my chart go down to 72. There we go. So I'll have 72 total payments, and each one of these payments is going to be $140.80. So I'm going to drag that value down. So the interest paid is our APR, which was 10% divided by 12, since we're doing 12 months, times that previous month's balance, and drag it down. Actually, before I even do this, let me set all these to two decimals. Just so it looks pretty. All right. Then amount to payment is, our amount to principal is our payment minus the amount going to interest, which is what's actually pretty good. We have more going to principal from the get-go than interest. Sometimes, especially with mortgages, it's very skewed where there's way more in interest than in principal. And then our loan balance is our old balance minus the amount we just paid off on our principal. So looking down, we see initially we've got a lot going to interest. That interest value is getting less. Principal value is getting more. And at the end, we've actually overpaid by 36 cents. So I need to adjust my last payment so it's 36 cents less. So I believe that's going to be, let's try 44. Yes, that worked out. So my last payment, I'm actually paying a little bit less so that I zero out the loan and don't have any money left over. Okay. So again, let's look at totals. I think totals are always really interesting. So our total amount paid is going to be the sum of all of our payments. Let's turn all these into dollars. So for this loan, you're borrowing $7,600. Your total amount that you're going to pay is $10,137.24. You can just drag this formula over. So our total to interest is a little over $2,500, and our total to principal is the $7,600 that we borrowed. So again, you're paying a little less than half the value of the loan in interest. Is it worth it? I don't know. That's up to you. But at least now when you go to borrow money, you'll be more aware of how much you're actually paying in interest and whether or not it is worth it to you to go ahead and have the item and take that hit in interest.